We at Think Less, Play Faster have four short video clips to share with you today to review a couple of teaching points related to positional play and playing with pressure. Let's take a look at this video. I'm going to stop it right here where you see 6-5 for the Senators and 3 playing completely on the left side of the ice backing up here. I don't understand this. As a defenseman, the one of your reference points is the face-off circles on both sides of the ice. Now, here we're giving up the middle of the ice. Two defensemen way over on the left-hand side of the ice, which is a real no-no. And it's going to result in a goal against here. You're going to see it in a second. This defenseman here should be playing inside the dots, playing and positioning himself somewhere around here. So he forces the puck carrier to the outside and takes away middle ice from him. And this 6-5 here should be playing at least middle ice, and there's some positional play issues. I'm going to back it up, and you see this pass going to be made to Taylor Hall, and you see 6-5 pinched down from the weak side defensive position. I think if you're going to make that kind of pinch, you want to play with pressure, come down and skate him off when he's going to get the puck if you're going to make that kind of a pinch from the weak side onto the strong side. Instead, 6-5 gets way over to the left-hand side of the ice and is out of position, and you're going to see what results here. He's going to get beat to a pass to middle ice, and the puck goes in the net, and it was completely preventable. Both D should have been playing between the dots, and it ends up causing them a goal. So the teaching point here is when you're coming back and you're defending middle ice through the neutral zone, always don't give away middle ice. The defenseman, by playing this close to the boards, is giving away middle ice, and he's giving time and space. What he wants to do is move over, force this player to beat him wide with speed, and he can turn and take him to the outside. This guy moves to the middle, and he has no trouble playing one-on-one, and we just have a two-on-two. So let's be smart and know where we are positionally on the ice as defensemen and try and play between the dots when you're defending the neutral zone. In this video clip, you're going to see a two-on-one, and we'll review the playing of a two-on-one from a defenseman's defensive perspective. Let's take a look at what happens here. We don't know what happened in the neutral zone to cause this turnover, but we'll just examine how the defenseman plays a two-on-one. The rule of thumb with a two-on-one is to play as a defenseman between the puck carrier and second forward to try and position yourself so that you're able to block a pass coming from the puck carrier. So you're trying to play in the middle, but you should be applying pressure and trying to force the puck carrier wide outside the dots as much as possible. And what that does is provide time for the back pressure and the back checker to provide defensive assistance. So in this case, I believe there's way too much time provided to the puck carrier, and the defenseman overplays the player without the puck and grants complete access to the middle of the ice to the puck carrier when he goes in and shoots and scores. So we'll review it again quickly, and I don't want to be too critical of the defenseman, but I do believe Had he played with a little more pressure and moved his feet laterally and tried to take this player back more on outside the dot position, still maintaining position between himself, the puck carrier, and the second forward, he would have had a better result here. I'd much rather see a puck carrier to make a great pass to beat me on a 2-on-1 than grant complete access to the net and a scoring chance. So I think he's playing too soft here, and he gives him complete access to the net and a goal results. So as a defenseman in a 2-on-1, force that player to the outside, make him make a good pass, and put some pressure on him to make a good shot from a bad angle. In this video, it's a 5-on-5 situation, and you're going to see a point shot goal. And I share this video with you again because it shows a lack of defensive pressure by the 5-player unit of the Ottawa Senators. It's what happens when you don't play the body and everyone's stick checking and providing way too much time and space. And when you allow a player to advance the puck below the goal line and the puck battles extends from the corner, you're always going to have more difficulty defending your zone. So in this case, you see 10 in the Senators playing the puck instead of playing the body. The puck's chipped ahead, and there's no coverage on this fellow here. So the puck goes from behind the net, moves out, and you see him move it up top. There's no up top coverage at all, and we get a good quick release from the point man and a goal results. I'll look at it quickly, and it's just a result of a lack of pressure, a lack of getting 5 guys in the box and winning the battle for the puck and recovery of the puck. And it's a situation where we're way too passive, 5 guys standing and watching instead of covering and applying pressure. You got to play better defense in this to win hockey games at that level. Again, way too much time and space, and a good point shot goal. This is our final video today, and we're going to see a 3-on-3 situation. And think less, play faster encourages playing with pressure. And in this situation, we believe there should have been more pressure applied and better communication by the defensive team to get better coverage in place here. So the player with the puck, in my opinion, is given way too much time. I'm not sure this is the battle he should be fighting, the strong side defenseman. I would much prefer to see him move his feet and force this player with the puck to the outside and played him with a lot tighter. This fellow should have then picked up this player to the net, and the instruction, he sticks his arm out and focuses on 16 here, trying to get this fella to go full speed and take this guy to the net. So what happens is we give way too much time and space to the puck carrier. This fella glides. You see his feet aren't even moving. He's got to be going full speed to get on to this fella here and take him to the net. Instead, he coasts, and instead of playing this fella on this fella and this fella here playing a 2-on-2 and having him pick up the trailer and applying pressure, we just simply back up, and allow the shooter to get a great shot on net, and he scores. So we'll watch it again quickly, but there's got to be better communication, and you got to apply pressure instead of backing up, and you can watch this fella here. He glides all the way in, and he's got to be on his horse going full speed to pick up this guy. This guy picking up his player, this guy taking him, and let's play with some pressure and stop giving all this backing up, and it ends up with a puck in your own net. Thanks for watching.